Hi, it's Karen here. Today I thought we would work in our journal that we made, our intuitive journal, because we haven't worked in that for a while. So I thought we would have a little look of what we've been doing. I think I did this one with you. I don't think I did this one with you. This was something that I was just playing with some inks and stuff. But anyway, I thought I would do a double page this time. So I've just got some bits and pieces that I haven't used in absolutely ages. And I thought we would just be intuitive and spontaneous, and let's just see what happens, see what reveals itself. So I'm just going to, with my pencil, I'm just going to make some marks nice and loosely, not thinking about anything really, just working, just letting it go. I've got my, excuse me, I'm going to stretch across you. I've found some really old pencils, and I'm literally just going to dab some paint straight from the tube. These are acrylic paints that I'm using, studio acrylics. So, and I'm just rubbing them along. Don't know where this is going to take us. It's exploration time. Let's see what happens. Quite like that. Don't mind that it's thick in some places and not in others. That's absolutely fine. I'm going to get some tissue and just make it quite wet, and then I'm going to drag it across and see what marks we get. I'm looking for texture really at this point. Now, I've got some ink that I'm going to be using as well. So this is waterproof ink, and this is a brown one. So what I'm going to do is very carefully. I found an old egg cup that I don't use. I use it for my artwork, and I'm just going to rub the ink, and then just make some lovely marks. Okay, a little goes an awful long way on these inks. They're fab. Okay, I better put the lid on, because don't you know what will happen? I'll knock it over and it'll go absolutely everywhere. Now, if you want to rub your brush over where you've painted, yeah, where you've dipped, great. Getting every scrap. I love these inks. I think they're great fun. I'm just gonna get some more tissue and just wipe out, just in case I want to use it again for something else. I also have been looking through my stash, and I found a found a stamp that I don't think I've even used it. So I thought, I'll use that I'll use that in a bit and see what marks we can make with that. I'm actually going to use this. This one's Studio. That's an opaque one. I love this colour. It's blue turquoise. It's just absolutely glorious. I'm just literally dipping it into the tip of the and I'm just rubbing it across, using it in diluted thick, you know. Let's see what it does. Again, just dabbing it just a little bit. Don't want masses of paint because we're only working in our little sketchbook, but that's all good. Just put some scratches in. Why not? We want to make some marks, don't we? It's starting to look a little bit more interesting. Just getting a little bit of this blue. I do love it. Now, if you want to change your brush up, you can, but I wanted to stick with this size brush because I wanted to see how it would work out. I didn't actually want to change things up too much. And I'm going to go back in and make some marks. We're just working in layers, really. This is about relaxing and just having fun with your paints and not worrying about how good it's going to look, or it's exploration. You're seeing what happens if I do this, what happens if I make that mark. This is the beauty of when you work in your sketchbooks and intuitively. It's just lets you be free, really. Okay, I want to use stronger marks, absolutely. I think I've got this lovely green gold by Golden. When I'm painting, I like to use this, and it's just beautiful. Just sings, really. Just gorgeous. This absolutely gorgeous colour, it just sings. And it just kind of, for me, it just brings it to life, really. I love it. So you can be as wild as you want. Your boat out, so to speak. And when you overlay the paint with the other ones that you've laid down, you get these wonderful textures that reveal themselves, which is just lovely. So I'm kind of going to limit it now to these remaining colours. I think that's going to be quite like that. Now, I'm thinking I'm just going to drop a little bit of black. Now, kill or cure with our lovely black. I'm literally just rubbing it round the edge. I'm not going to put masses on, so I'm just going to drop these. Actually, I'm just going to splatter, I think. You get more of a spontaneous look when you splatter. I think it's nice. I'm just going to rub my brush across it again. Yeah, maybe just put some the lid on that, I think. Now, yeah, so it's building up nicely. I'm tempted now just to put, oh sorry, did I jog you? Sorry about that, folks. I'm tempted just to put a little bit of, I'm just going to drop a bit, just some gesso. Just drop that on my paper. And I'm just going to pick up a bit and just... rub that in, maybe knock some things back, give us that nice chalkiness that gesso gives us, quite like that. I don't think it's dry enough yet, but I think I'm going to just get my ink pad. What happens if I just do shapes? How does that look? Just gives us another. Just going to take this bit of gesso off. Ever so carefully, take a little bit of the actually don't. I don't know what it says, but don't really need to know, do we? Let's try this piece here. Yeah, that's fun. Let's just wipe off the stamp just so I can come to use it again. But yeah, I'd forgotten all about that I'd even had that. I think I might use one of the focal points that we did. How does that look? What do you think? A bit too big? A bit too clumsy? What about that one? Yeah, I quite like that one. I like that one. Not sure really. Oh, this might work. It's a. Do you know what? I'm just going to put the one on. That's what I'm going to do. I think we need any more than that. So I'll just get the glue. Well, I would urge you to let yours dry. My gesso is still wet, but I figured, you know, we're pushing the boat, we're exploring. So let's see what happens when we do this. Let's just see. Put him down. Find some old book page or something like that. Maybe a piece of As you can see, it's still wet, and this makes a great background for maybe you would like to put, you know, in your journal, because I've got some photos that I've had printed of my family, and they're just fun little snaps when we were on holiday. Nice and natural. And you know, I don't know about you, but my photos tend to stay on my phone or my camera, and then I download it onto my PC, and that's where it stays really. I've made a New Year's resolution that I'm going to start to show my photographs and so they're more accessible. And I thought, if I make a series of these little books, these little sketchbooks, and then I can put some photographs in there, then that would be great. And I'm just going through with my pencil again, just to let's just rough these edges up a bit. Because why not? I think pencil is a very underused piece of equipment. I'd be lost without my pencil, really. The pencils. If you're like me, got loads. And I'm just now just rubbing my pencil along, seeing on the side what happens if I do that. What do I get? Almost like rubbing. Well, it is rubbing. When we were children, we used to get coins and things and rub them and get the image. And yeah, it's fun when you look back and put the things you did when you were children. And I'm just going to get my pen, my brush, and just move it about. And I think I'm going to use the brown. I'm just going to, again, I think the splatters are lovely. Just the tip of my water on my brush. Maybe just if you don't like it, you can take it out. If you do, splatter a little bit more. Totally up to you. So I'm just gonna have a look and see what I think. Yeah, I think I'm just going to now get my pencil again and just wiggle my way through these splatters. Maybe pick them up and, you know, who knows what interesting effects we'll get. I think I will just have a little look at this. So maybe pop a... No, that's too much. It's I kind of want more of a little one, really. Oh, what about you? Let's have a look at you. Well, that's quite sweet, because it's not the same, so does that work? Or that one? Are you shouting at me, saying, yes, that one's better? That one's... I'm going to go with this one. Let's go with this one. Just... I'm not... being so precious with this, because I probably will, well, I will cover these up with photos and maybe little anecdotes of what I see in a magazine or something, something that will take my that I'll look and think, yeah, I quite like that. You can write something on there if you like. I quite like doing this, and I'm just writing a little bit of what I did today. And things that impressed me, and also things that didn't. I think I'm going to put a bit of writing up here. Now, you don't have to write it so everyone can read it if that's not what you like. I call this my doctor's writing, because I, believe it or not, can read this, but if somebody saw this, they'd say, what on earth have you written? And it's just about having a really nice afternoon with my daughter today, which is a gift, really, because she's terribly busy, and it's just wonderful when we can make some time for each other, and it's and today was that day, so win-win-win for me. And there we have it. That's just, there we go. Anyway, that's my intuitive painting background in the sketchbook. Lots of influences of today, but yeah, just exploring, really. I hope it's inspired you to work intuitively in your sketchbook, or even in your journal. That would be great. So I'll say goodbye for now. Take care, and I'll see you real soon. Bye.